What's going on, Halo fans? Luke the Notable here. In this video, we're going to kind of show you how to beat lag. Lag can be insanely frustrating whenever you're trying to play some Halo online. I played with a laggy connection for a long time. Yeah, that's right. Not every YouTuber has an insane, awesome internet connection. When I moved into this new apartment that I'm in now, the internet did get fixed, or I should say upgraded. We got upgraded to a much higher internet package, also cost a lot more, but we did run into a problem. Right now, we only have one cable running all of our internet connection through. Normally, most setups have multiple cables doing this. So if we have multiple devices at use at the same time, like a computer, laptop, phone, streaming Netflix, whatever, my ping goes through the roof and therefore my Halo experience does go into the toilet. So this video is going to be me going over some of the things that I do to survive in Halo 5 Guardians Online when my connection is bad. Because even if you have a good connection, sometimes you're forced to play on expanded or the servers are crap and you might need these tips. Tip number one is you want to optimize your own connection. If you're not using an Ethernet cable to connect your router to your Xbox, you're doing it wrong. Using Wi-Fi for your Xbox just increases your overall latency and makes everything terrible. If you can, use an Ethernet cable. It helps a ton. And I know for some of you this is pretty much impossible, but if you can, make sure that most devices that are using internet are turned off in your house. If your connection's already pretty bad, having tons of devices on the same connection is only going to make your ping go up, and therefore make your games worse. My second tip is try to lead your shots whenever possible when shooting at someone that is moving. This is tough to do when someone's strafing, and I wouldn't necessarily recommend that. I have a separate tip for that later. But if someone's moving away from you, lead your shot just a little bit to make up for any server lag. This will make it so even if you're a couple milliseconds behind the dedicated server, it'll make your shots clean and accurate. My third tip is that when you are strafing and you're going to use a thrust strafe, make sure to use a thrust strafe in the middle of your gunfight, not at the end. If you're playing on a slow connection, there is always a chance that someone on the enemy team is playing with a faster connection and therefore will get information from the dedicated server first. This will mean that their information is a little bit tiny, just milliseconds ahead of yours. If you thrust at the end of your gunfight, you run the risk of the dedicated server not knowing that you thrusted because your connection is too slow. Therefore, the player that is shooting at you will get the kill because you never thrusted out of the way of their bullet. So if you know you're playing on a laggy connection, the servers are bad, or you're playing on expanded, make sure to thrust in the middle of your gunfights. It can help a lot. Overall though, thrusting at the end of your gunfight is definitely the better way to go to get away from the person shooting you and line up the last headshot. Unfortunately, that's the way it is. That's why in Halo it is very important to assess every single game you're in. You need to know the conditions of the server to tell you how to play. My fourth tip is that automatic weapons are your friend. Now, unfortunately, you won't find any automatic weapons in the HCS 2017 playlist, but every other playlist in Halo pretty much has some mixing of automatic and non-automatic weapons. Automatics, because of their larger spread, are generally pretty easy to use even under laggy conditions. Now, of course, automatics aren't always the best gun to use. Many times you're going to get outranged, so it's important to know when to switch from your pistol to your automatic, but if you play on a really laggy connection, lean on your automatics a little bit more. It can be insanely frustrating to try to win gunfights while super laggy. You also want to develop the skill of pre-shooting. Pre-shooting is shooting at a corner before the enemy player is around it. You want to make sure not to shoot too early, because then the enemy that you're trying to kill will just not come around the corner, and you also want to make sure not to do it too late, or you might miss some shots. Pre-shooting is great for making up for the low response time of some laggy connections. My fifth tip is that you want to use weapons like the battle rifle and the designated marksman rifle for a couple of reasons. The first reason is that these weapons have a much longer range, which means that they have a longer red reticle range, or the range at which bullet magnetism and auto-aim and all of those things take into effect, making shooting even with a laggy connection much easier. Also, I find that the battle rifle catches enemy Spartans with its three-shot burst much easier in laggy situations than the pistol or the DMR. And my sixth and final tip to help yourself in a laggy situation is you need to make sure to aim at the chin. Now, this only applies for any sort of precision type weapons, but you want to make sure to aim at the chin and not at the head. You want to aim at the chin because the chin will still count as a headshot if you look at a player's hitbox. However, if you're off because of a laggy connection and the dedicated server calculates as you moving a little bit to the right or the left, you will still hit the player. Whereas if you're aiming directly in the center of their head, you may not. If you had a perfect connection, the best place to aim would be dead center of the head, because you could count on every time you aimed at that head, that is actually where the dedicated server has placed that Spartan's head. If you're playing on a laggy connection, or even just expanded though, there may be some discrepancies between the two. Aiming at the chin just helps prevent you from missing that final shot because you thought you were shooting at a head when you actually weren't. If you liked this video and want to learn more about Halo, one of the easiest ways is with Audible. Audible is a service from Amazon that offers a massive amount of audiobooks to its subscribers, and Audible is currently offering a 30-day audiobook service. You'll get access to 2 free audiobooks, and yes, all of the Halo novels are on audiobook and available right now. I personally like listening to these audiobooks while online playing some Halo, and of course, you can cancel any time. If you're interested in learning all about the Fall of Reach or a resident expert on what the ladies like, go down to the link in the description and to sign up for your absolutely free 30-day trial of Audible. And if this offer didn't already sound like the most notable thing you've ever heard, the 2 books you get with the trial are yours to keep forever, even if you cancel. So click on that link down in the video description to get your 2 free audiobooks with Audible completely risk-free. And that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please comment down below. It is one of my favorite parts about YouTube. Everyone, stay notable, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.